Time to break your magical girl outfits out of the closet, because the Prisma Ilya rerun is right around the corner. Hello everyone, Soberoni of G&A Reviews here, with a servant spotlight for the servant that you're contractually obligated to roll for if you have Ilya, Miyu. We'll be examining her stats and skills, as well as going over pointers on how to utilize her effectively and an overall grade, comparing her to how she stacks up to the other 4-star servants. And if you guys are looking forward to this deep dive into one of Prisma's best girls, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe, and ring my bell so that you can catch all of these spotlight videos as they go up and help out the channel. Now, onto Miyu's stats. Miyu has a max HP of 12,005 and a max attack of 8,629, which becomes 7,766 due to her class modifier. Compared to the other 4-star casters, Miyu has slightly above average HP and about average attack. But compared to the other 4-star servants overall, her attack stat is expectedly very low, while her HP is on the higher end of the spectrum. When it comes to her command cards, Miyu has 3 hits on her quick card, 2 hits on her arts, 3 hits on her buster, and 4 hits on her extra card. She has an NP gain rate of 0.81% and a star rate of 10.9%. Miyu's overall stat spread is heavily focused on defense, which is normal for a support-focused servant. Her NP gain is quite good, thanks in large part to her triple arts card deck and high NP gain rate. But her star generating is poor from only having 1 quick card. Taking a look at her skills, Miyu's first skill is Cheerful Type Mystic Code, Younger Sister, Rank A. This increases her arts card effectiveness for 3 turns, between 20 and 30%, and it increases her own crit damage for 3 turns or 3 attacks, between 20 and 30%, both depending on level. Her second skill is Maiden's Willpower, Rank B. This grants herself Guts for 1 time, lasting 3 turns, and reviving her with between 1000 and 2000 HP, depending on level, and it also gives her a 1-time debuff immunity that lasts for 3 turns. And finally, her last skill is Wish of the Child God, Rank EX. This skill charges one ally's NP gauge between 20 and 30%, and it also increases their buff success rate for 3 turns between 20 and 40%, both depending on level. For passives, Miyu has Magic Resistance Rank B, which increases her own debuff resist by 17.5%, and Unlimited Prana Supply Rank B, which charges her own NP gauge by 4%, every turn. Moving on to her deck and Noble Phantasm, Miyu has an arts deck with Quick Arts 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 Buster and an Arts Noble Phantasm. Her Noble Phantasm is Wish Upon a Star. This is a support Noble Phantasm that grants Miyu a special buff, which increases the party's NP gauge by 10% every turn. It also heals the party between 500 and 1000 HP, depending on level, and it generates between 5 to 25 crit stars every turn, depending on overcharge. However, this Noble Phantasm does come with the demerit of decreasing Miyu's HP by 3000. When it comes to her ascension materials, I'm sure many of you will be thrilled to know that Miyu needs quite a few heroes proofs and void dust. For level ascension, she requires 18 heroes proof, 16 void dust, 6 spirit roots, and 8 phoenix plumes. Heroes proof is farmable at the pirate ship in Okeanos with a 58% drop rate. Void dust can be farmed at Charlotte in America, where it has a 64% drop rate. Spirit roots are best found at the Holy City in Camelot, where they have a 12% drop rate. And finally, phoenix plumes have a 35% drop rate at the Town Hall in Salem. For skill leveling, Miyu requires 24 void dust, 36 heroes proof, 12 Lanugos, and 20 shells per skill. Lanugos can be farmed at Village 67 in Lost Belt 2, where they have an 18% drop rate, and shells drop at the Observatory in Babylonia with a 40% drop rate. With Miyu's release, the entire Prisma squad is finally here. At last, you can send Kuro, Ilya, and Miyu into battle together. Just hopefully not in public, or you may get yourself added to a list. But aside from adding a bit more flavor and lore to the game, what else is Miyu capable of? Well, as a caster, she unsurprisingly boasts very high HP and some pretty good NP gain. However, she does have low attack and star generating, which isn't too much of a problem because Miyu is all about that support life. Her third skill, Wish of the Child of God, charges an ally's NP gauge by 30%, and increases their buff success rate by 40%. Naturally, this is a phenomenal skill for enabling NP spam and farming teams, which is Miyu's entire gimmick. A 30% charge in particular is significant because it can be used in combination with the Mages Association Mystic Code and many of the free event craft essences that give 50% NP charge, so that a servant can Noble Phantasm on turn 1. The buff to success rate also provides niche usage to some servants who rely on chance-based skills like Imperial Privilege. Miyu also has self-buffing skills, most notably her first skill, Cheerful Type Mystic Code, which buffs her Archcard effectiveness by 30% for 3 turns, and it gives her a 30% crit buff for 3 turns or 3 hits. Now this is a bit of a confusing skill because it's not targetable, and for the most part, Miyu doesn't benefit at all from the crit buff, since she has such low damage and star weight. However, the arch buff is very useful for further boosting Miyu's NP gain, and considering that most of her deck is arch cards, she gets a lot of mileage from this high uptime buff. Finally, Miyu has a defensive skill in Maiden's Willpower, which grants her Guts and a one-time debuff immunity for 3 turns. While nothing amazing, this is a solid bit of hard defense, which Miyu desperately needs for reasons that we'll get into a bit later. The debuff immunity can also be helpful for challenge quests or tough fights where enemies can spam debuffs. For skill order, I recommend leveling her NP charge first, since it is by far her best skill, and it's going to be the key for setting up NP spam and farming teams. Followed by her arch buff for better NP gain, and then her guts last. Miyu's Noble Phantasm is rather unique. It grants her a buff that passively gives all allies 10% NP charge, a heal, and it generates stars every turn for 3 turns. But it comes at the cost of draining Miyu's HP by 3,000. Now there is a lot to say about this NP. Starting with the positives first, this is basically a mini Garden of Avalon, which is amazing considering that Garden of Avalon is arguably one of the most OP Noble Phantasms in the game. Miyu basically gives the entire team a ton of powerful buffs that every servant can use. Crit stars to improve DPS and potentially set up crit teams, healing so that your team can stall out harder fights, and NP charge so that she can enable NP spam and farming strategies. What's more, because Miyu has such good NP gain as well as a passive that gives her NP charge, it's very easy for Miyu to spam out this NP and stack it so that the team can get double the benefits. And that's pretty much what Miyu's entire kit is designed to do. Enable her to spam out this Noble Phantasm so that she can provide the team with a ton of NP charge. In a sense, she can be a perpetual NP battery, much like Merlin. However, this also comes with a huge downside in the form of that demerit. Losing 3,000 HP every time she Noble Phantasms is no joke. That's a huge chunk of health, and this problem is compounded by the fact that she is entirely designed to spam her NP. So her biggest strength is also Miyu's biggest weakness. And this demerit is so detrimental that it single-handedly holds Miyu back from doing what the rest of her kit is designed to do. Unless you have her at NP5, Miyu will lose health faster than she can recover it by using her NP. Which means that after around 2 NPs, she's almost always going to be on death's door. This makes her unsuitable for longer fights, especially boss fights. The other issue with this Noble Phantasm is that the buff that it gives doesn't go to each servant individually, but instead is tied to Miyu herself. So if Miyu dies or has her buffs removed, the entire team will lose all of that healing, that star generating, and that NP gain. So that means even if you do have a strategy to kill off Miyu, you can't keep all of the buffs that she gives. But believe it or not, this demerit isn't Miyu's only drawback. She also has no real way of buffing the team's damage. Many other arch supports are able to provide attack or arch card buffs in addition to NP charge, and Miyu's only arch buff is for herself. So to put it simply, nearly all of Miyu's utility and support capability is tied to her Noble Phantasm that kills her. It isn't all doom and gloom for Miyu though. As I mentioned earlier, her third skill is still quite powerful for farming teams, and she does have some capability to stick around for fights thanks to her guts. Team building is key for Miyu. You want to make sure that you always stick her with another support who is capable of healing her to compensate for that demerit. I recommend servants with a strong targetable or AoE heal like Media Lily, Tamamo, and Hans. I typically don't mention Hans because he's really broken, so you should assume that he's excellent with everyone. However, in this case, Hans has especially good synergy with Miyu, since his heal can offset the demerit on Miyu's Noble Phantasm. Likewise, Tamamo and Media Lily have tremendous healing capabilities that can keep Miyu alive for a long time. Aside from having another healer, Miyu can be especially useful when supporting Arc Servants who rely on being able to spam their NPs for damage, like Finn, Sieg, and Kuro. Finn and Sieg are both top tier farmers who rely on teammates with strong NP batteries to set them up, and Miyu can provide more than enough NP charge for them in quick battles. Kuro also benefits a lot from Miyu's NP battery and star generating, which when combined with her own strong NP gain, can set her up for multiple back-to-back NPs. Miyu's Bond CE is Recollections of My Mother. It increases the party's NP generating by 15%. It's a very good Bond CE considering that Miyu's entire playstyle revolves around improving the team's NP gain. But aside from her Bond CE, I recommend using craft essences that improve Miyu's own NP gain so that she can stack her buffs. CEs like Magical Girl of Sapphire, Prisma Cosmos, Painting Summer, and Divine Banquet. There are a few more niche CEs that you can use on Miyu for more specific situations, like Demonic Bodhisattva for more star generating on crit teams, and School of Caldia, Bride Training, or Maiden of a Flower Patio if you're having trouble keeping Miyu alive. In the future, I recommend Annual General Meeting, which drops this April. It buffs Arch Card effectiveness and P gain, and generates stars, so it's excellent on Miyu. As for command codes, I recommend Maiden of Orleans. It heals for 1000 HP when you attack with the engraved card, which can again help Miyu stick around for a little bit longer. Overall, Miyu is a situationally useful NP battery that is greatly hampered by some significant drawbacks. She can work well for farming setups thanks to her strong NP charge on her third skill, and provided that she can stay alive, she can enable many Arch Servants to spam their NPs while providing the team with plenty of crit stars. However, the 3000 HP demerit holds her back from reaching her full potential because it prevents her from continuously using her Noble Phantasm. In addition, she lacks any offensive buffs for the team, requires a lot of babysitting from other supports, and because her NP buff is tied to her life, it makes her buffs very unreliable. So all in all, Miyu gets a C- from me. I do think that she's still usable as a support in some specific farming setups, mostly thanks to her third skill, but outside of that, she really struggles to stay alive long enough for her buffs to have any real impact, unless you design the whole team around keeping her alive. And she doesn't offer anything unique that can't be found in other Arch supports, both at her own rarity and lower, like Paracelsus, Lan Ling, and Caster Gil. And those are my thoughts on Miyu. It really sucks to see one demerit hold the servant back so much. And I really hope that Miyu gets a buff sometime soon, because not only is she really fun to play, but it's really cool that she has so much synergy with Kuro and Ilya, and I'd love to use her alongside them more often. But what do you think? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like, and consider subscribing if you really enjoyed the video. Join the party over at our Discord, chill with us on Twitch, and follow us on Twitter. And I'll see you all in the next Servant Spotlight. Sobroni out. Later.